So welcome to yet another day of powerful learnings to help you create your knowledge-based business leveraging digital systems and tools. So far, we have looked at your unique positioning blueprint, your personal positioning blueprint, your business positioning blueprint, and also the market readiness blueprint with the GPS system, and identified your the course that you would like to create, identified your target audience, identified a unique name for your course, right? And also we are building on the 3R content bank, which is right, relevant, and risk-free. And we have seen so far how to build your right, relevant, risk-free content bank using the GPS system. So as you see, we are building the foundation of your knowledge business so that you can build skyscraper on this foundation, right? With absolute clarity and communication, value adding communication, and high converting content. So far, we have merged all the blueprints together. First, you worked on your thoughts and brought them to paper using pen and paper. You first worked on your thoughts and brought your thoughts to paper using pen, and then created a better version of the work that we have done so far. And now you brought this draft version, which is also a better version, onto the blueprints, the KDM blueprints that have been given to you, right? Market readiness blueprint and your 3R content, high converting content blueprint, right? So we are moving ahead towards your journey of building your knowledge business. So now we will learn what kind of course to create. What should be the course outline? What should be the curriculum of your course? How to make your course interesting, engaging, entertaining, that people look forward to working with you? Would you like to do that? Would you like to know how to create engaging courses which people want to come back and look at it, right? And revisit it again and again, right? So in the knowledge business, the revenue model, the way it works is having repeat sales from your existing customers, right? So first you attract your target audience with right communication, which is the pain statement and the gain statement. Once they are okay to work with you, they like what you have to offer, they share their contact details, and a stranger visitor becomes a lead. Now, people do not simply give their name and contact just like that. Law of the online world, givers gain. So you will have to give them something. You are giving them your influence building videos, but you that is called lead generation. There is an interest that is being generated, but you need to make sure you capture that interest as leads in your list building system. So lead generation via your videos, blogs, podcast, right? But where are the leads coming, right? You have to make sure you channelize them into your list building system, which is lead capture mechanism. The problem is most of the people don't have a lead capture mechanism, and that's where your lead leaks happen. So one of the lead generation mechanism is your videos, your influence building videos on YouTube, but you have to make sure that you have a call to action where you're directing them to, if you want to do it in a crude way, which I would say not a good way to generate capture and engage leads. I want you to be on a list building system so that there's a lot of automations possible and it simplifies your work. Time is limited, so how you can make the most of your time. And a good thing is there are a lot of such solutions available. All you need to do is be ready to invest in those solutions, which can simplify your life so that you can focus on what you do best. So one way of generating leads is through your videos or blogs, podcast. Other way of generating leads is having a lead magnet on your website, which is giving them something of value so that they give their contact details in return, in exchange of the value that you are giving them. So now let us look at what are the lead magnets, different types of lead magnets that you can create. right? So an assessment is a great lead magnet, right? Say personality assessment or leadership assessment or gap assessment, right? Know your type, know your leadership style, know your personality type, know your passion, right? The assessment, okay. Then PD ebooks are a great lead magnets. Your templates are great lead magnets. Okay. So your mini course is also a great lead magnet. Okay. So the whole idea is the purpose of this lead magnet, the intention behind creating this lead magnet is to let your target audience know of your capabilities, right? What is it that you can do with them, right? So that is the intention of a lead magnet, right? So depending upon what lead magnets you would like to create, I want you to now list down what is the lead magnet that you think it can be a tutorial, okay, in the form of a PDF, right? Templates, blueprints, these all make great lead magnets, okay? It could be just, it could be just a JPG file with which talks about the entire business model, or if you're in stock, it will show, the various ways to read a stock, whatever, you would know your stuff well. So what is it that you can give for free, but it should be of value? And so that you can get the name and contact details. So lead magnet, a mini course is a great lead magnet. So how you can design a mini course now, whatever you have built so far, your content bank, right? That one pain, one gain, and 10 questions for that gain. So these, you can just identify three questions out of these 10 questions. We have a mix of what, why, and how questions, and you can create one mini course out of it, right? So whatever content bank you are building, a mini course can be a 20 minute, 3-4 videos, making 20 minutes, 5 minutes, 6 minute videos, or a 30 minute video kind of, which are learning. It's a learning. You're giving them some value. So mini courses are a great lead magnet right now. Okay. Because not many people offer them. It requires some effort from your side to create lead magnets, a mini course, ebook, PDF, templates are faster. Assessments are also faster, provided you do it in a software-based assessment. Otherwise, it can also become time-consuming for you. So it depends on the nature of your products that you've decided to create, what kind of lead magnet you would like to create. Simpler is ebook, a PDF, okay, or a mini course, because anyways, you're recording your influence building content. You can club your 3 or 4 good videos and make a mini course out of it and put that as a lead magnet on your website. So this is a monetization strategy. This is a lead generation strategy as well, right? Now, what else can you do? So we have lead magnet to collect the leads, generate leads, and capture them using necessary digital systems and tools, which we'll cover later, right? So once you have the leads, now these people have come for free, right? Now this lead magnet will be free or very, very low ticket. If you want to still qualify serious leads versus quality leads, serious leads, so then you can also have a very low ticket price point, 49 rupees, 99 rupees for a lead magnet. Then now just by selling 49.99 products, you're not going to make a business model, or your business is not going to sustain. It is just a qualifier for you, serious versus non-serious, right? So now, as I said, the funnel of the knowledge business is first let the strangers and visitors enter into your world through your lead magnet. Now, if they like, it's a conceptual offering again. Once the lead magnets are interested to work with you, you can have your low ticket offering. Again, the low ticket offering is a conceptual concept. It's not implementation. It's concepts, your deep insights and wisdom, your experience, expertise in the form of concepts, unique concepts, concepts that, and the way you teach them, the way you are helping them get skilled, the way you are helping them overcome their gaps, the way you are transforming people with your conceptual knowledge, with whatever course you have decided to create, right? So it's called Tripwire, which is a low ticket offering. Low ticket offering is anywhere from 999 rupees to 499 rupees. Okay. Right now, these are the rates. It may change, depends. Okay. So it's a low ticket offering where you are now converting your leads to customers, paid customers, right? So now we will look, now this, these are the initial stages, which are the most critical and crucial stages of building your knowledge business. Most of the time people think, oh, it's a 99 rupees thing only, so I'm not going to give much because I'm just getting 99. So you're not getting 99, you are getting an opportunity to let your target audience know what you are capable of and qualify their interest to work with you. The intent is that, right? So if 1,000 people come for free via your lead magnet, or even if you're doing a Facebook campaign, a 99 rupees campaign, or a free giving something for free campaign. So say 1,000 people come into your funnel in the free offering, then out of that 80-20 rule, generally everywhere for conversions, but right now even 10% conversions you do from your free to a low ticket program, say 100 people should opt in for your low ticket program. And that is why it is low ticket, because people will not directly jump from free to your premium offering, 50,000, 1 lakh, 2 lakh, 5 lakh, whatever it is. So this is the funnel of your knowledge business model, the sales funnel, right? So the low ticket offering is again, conceptual offering, which you can have a duration about 90 minutes to 2 hours, but they will be bite-sized videos, small videos, 5 minutes, 6 minutes, less than 10 minutes. And if the nature of your course demands 20 minutes because it is a technical concept, then it's fine. Okay. But mindset shifts and all, don't try to give too many things in one particular course content. We will look at the how to design your 2 hour program, or you can call it a 3 day program, day one, day two, day three, how you can create a course which will be priced, a high converting course, which is priced less, so that people again are moving from free, from leads to your paid customers. And then from there, you will be creating your core product, which is an implementation. For example, if you're saying people what it takes to have good health, okay? So exercise, water, balanced nutrition. So in the, that is your conceptual offering. Now in the implementation, you will actually help them sign on to an implementation program where you're giving them daily exercises and monitoring as well. You have an accountability system in place. You're giving them their daily nourishment meal plan, right? You're also giving them their daily water intake and and giving them a process to remind them to take water, and you are driving it, right? You're helping them implement. So your core product is an implementation product. Right. So if I'm in the business, start your business from scratch niche. And if I'm saying what it takes to build your business, I have four pillars to start your business. So I give all the concept. But now someone who really wants to start a business, I actually make them do, what is your idea? Write down your idea. Whose problem it is solving? Again, you know, the GPS system, then idea viability, feasibility. Right. So it's proper action taking, right? Building your business plan, how to create a business plan, right? So that becomes all part of implementation, right? So that is an implementation offering, which is your core product. And you can price, look at the current market rates in this specific year. We are doing this session in 2021. So currently market rates for your, depending upon your past credibility, is anywhere from 9999 to 49999. Okay, depends on your credibility, past experience, expertise, and look at how others are pricing it in the market. So you be in alignment to the current prices based on your credibility, though. Okay, we have seen how to establish your credibility, your past experience. What is your current revenue income at present? What is the value of your 1 hour? Based on that, and looking at the market rates and how many people you expect to go through the program, based on all of that, you decide the price of your tripwire and core product. Okay, all pricing will be done based on that. Okay, we will look at that in some other session, how to price your products, right? So now this core product is an implementation product. So it can be 30 days, 60 days, 21 days, 90 days, 3 months, whatever way you want to do it. It can be group, it can be just simply recorded sessions or a mix of live and recorded sessions, right? And then the next, so let's assume you're pricing your Tripwire at 19,999 rupees. So your lead magnet free, your low Tripwire, assuming it is at 2,999, your core product can be at 14,999 or 19,999. Let's take that or 9,999. Let's put that. Whatever is relevant to your course or program, just take that. Then what will be your profit maximizer? Now, 1,000 people came for free, 100 opted for Tripwire, which is at price at, say, 2,999. 100 people opted for that. So 3,000 into 100, you've got your 3 lakhs straight away, right? And from that, 10% of 100, which is 10 people, will opt in for your implementation. Say it is a 60-day program or a 90-day program, and you're pricing it at 10,000 rupees, okay? Assume, for simplicity of calculation. So 10 people paying you 10,000 rupees. How much is that? 1 lakh rupees. So you're doing the implementation program in, you're getting 1 lakh rupees. So 10 people paying you 10,000 rupees for your implementation program. See where money, more money has come? 100 people paying you 3,000 rupees, right? At the entry point is more crucial point, okay? Now core product and then your profit maximizer. If someone really wants to work closely 1:1 with you, it could be a group format or a personal 1:1, then it becomes your profit maximizer, where you sign up for personal consulting and you say that your personal consulting is like 1 lakh, right? Or 3 lakhs. So one person will come on 3 lakh, for example. So 100 people came on 3,000 rupees, okay? 10 people came on 10,000 rupees and one person is coming on 3 lakh rupees. That's how you build, that's the revenue model. And that is how it works, because in the online programs, you cannot take anyone directly. You do a seminar and pitch your 20,000 offering, 30,000 offering. It does not work like that. You have to take them through stages and you have to keep qualifying their interest. And you only work with people who are serious with you and are ready to invest their time, money and other resources with you. Make sense? So this is how the revenue model or the sales funnel of the knowledge business model works. So today we looked at how to ideate on your lead magnet and how a mini course can become your lead magnet, and the outline of mini course also comes from your content bank, right? Now we will look in depth how to create your Tripwire, a 2-hour course, a 90-minute course, and how your day one, day two, day three, 3-day program makes a good Tripwire, where you're giving enough time to people to complete that. It's up to them. They can finish in one day also, but ideally you will outline it as a 3-day, day one, day two, and day three. So tomorrow we will look at how to design the curriculum of your low ticket offering, which is Tripwire. What should be there in day one? What should be there in day two? And what should be there in day three, right? So I look forward to seeing you tomorrow once again, and then we will look at how to design your low ticket offering. So till then, keep growing, keep evolving, and I look forward to serving you with deep, powerful insights that truly matter for your growth.